Hey, this is Presh Talwalkar. I received this problem by email because it's going viral on Facebook with thousands of people arguing about the correct answer. How smart are you? A guy walks into a store and steals a $100 bill from the register without the owner's knowledge. He then buys $70 worth of goods using the $100 bill, and the owner gives $30 in change. How much money did the owner lose? Was it $30, $70, $100, $130, $170, or $200? Can you figure it out? Give this problem a try, and when you're ready, keep watching the video for the correct answer. In some math problems, and in this story, it helps to break the problem down into different parts. So at first, we'll only consider the first part of the story. A guy walks into a store and steals a $100 bill from the register without the owner's knowledge. At this point, how much does the owner lose? Everyone agrees the owner loses $100. The owner is minus $100 from the initial part of the story. So now, let's separately consider just the second part of the story. Imagine someone buys $70 worth of goods using a $100 bill, and the owner gives $30 in change. How much would you say the owner has lost in just this part of the story? Well, if someone buys $70 worth of goods using a $100 bill, you would expect the owner to give $30 in change. In fact, the owner is overseeing this transaction. So the owner here is not losing any money. The owner is, you could say, zero in this transaction. So now we put these two stories together. The total loss will be the sum of these two parts of the stories. So we can add negative 100 and zero to get that the total loss is $100. The owner is negative $100 from before the story started. So the correct answer is the owner lost $100. Now there's one technicality if you want to really overthink this problem and go into the accounting details. Now when someone buys $70 worth of goods in a store, it's not because the goods are worth $70 to the owner. What happens here is the owner is getting a $100 bill and gives back $30 in change, but the goods have some value V. This is usually going to be less than $70. So you could say the owner is actually losing the value of the goods, but then getting a net $70 because it's the $100 bill minus the $30 and change. So here the owner loses V minus 70, or you could say the owner is 70 minus V in terms of the cash position. So if you were to take these two stories now, you add up the results. The owner ultimately loses $30 plus the value V of the goods. So if we assume the value V is $70, which you say $70 worth of goods, then you would say the owner lost $100. So you could still arrive at the same answer of $100, but this is a little more accurate in terms of pure accounting. So why are so many people getting this problem wrong? Well, one of the common answers is there's a $200 loss to the owner. Many people think this is because in the first part of the story, the owner loses $100 that's stolen, and then in the second part of the story, the owner loses another $100 because the owner is giving up $7 worth of goods and $30 in change. So the mistake here is that it's not taking into account the owner is also getting a $100 bill. So when you take that other part of the story where you get the $100 bill, that will adjust the total by plus 100. And when you do that, that means the owner ultimately lost $100 in total. Another common answer is that the owner had $130 loss. This is from the stolen $100 bill and the $30 in change. Well, the problem with this answer is it's not taking into account that the owner also gave up $70 in goods, but also got a $100 bill. So when you take into account these transactions, the net result would be the owner losing $100, which is negative 100. So to summarize, most of the incorrect responses either didn't add or subtract the numbers correctly, or they didn't take into account every transaction. It seems the fact that in the second half of the story, the person used the stolen dollar bill, somehow people don't treat that as a genuine $100 bill. That is $100 that the owner is getting back. So when you take into account every single transaction and you treat it correctly as either a loss or a gain for the owner, you end up that the owner lost $100. Did you figure it out? Thanks for watching this video. Please subscribe to my channel. I make videos on math and game theory. You can catch me on my blog, Mind Your Decisions, which you can follow on Facebook, Google Plus, and Patreon. You can catch me on social media at Presh Talwalker. And if you like this video, please check out my books. There are links in the video description.